Okay, here we go, Paul. Let's look at Sonos.
So we're going back to the Y charts because that's why we're in beta mode. $1.4 billion company. We have a PE of 231. That's an X. Great margin though. 20.4% on, market cap is 5 billion.
Oh, 5 billion, okay.
Sorry. 20.49% in the last quarter in terms of, but in the last year they had 3% profit margin or so. So not that great there. I don't know if that's a check or an X. It's actually technically an X. So we'll give it an X because it's based on the last year.
Do you want to look at the revenue?
Of course we do.
Revenue growth over the past 5 years? Pillar number three, baby.
Okay. 843 million to 1.3 billion. Check mark there. So there's definite revenue growth the last 5 years and it's very consistently growing. Okay.
How about profit growth?
And the profit growth is going from a negative 69 million to... to negative 20 million X. Oh, sorry, check mark. That's a check mark. Because it is losing less money. So guys, this company has lost money every year since it's been publicly traded. That sounds awesome. Let's look at the shares outstanding.
Mm-hmm. This is pillar number five.
Another X, 88.8 million to 110 million. So not only are they losing money every single year, they're also diluting you as an owner. 5 years ago, you had 88 million shares outstanding. Now you have 110 million. If you owned a million shares 5 years ago, that buys you less of the company than it does today. More of the company back then than it does today.
Free cash flow growth over the past 5 years?
Well, balance sheet. You want to go to cash over.
Oh, I missed it. Pillar number six is assets over.
Total current assets over total current liabilities, 455 million. Total liabilities, only 556. So they have enough cash on hand to pay off all of their debts. This is a very, very important thing that I love. Major, major check marks there. They have enough cash to pay off all their debts. That's like you having enough money in your personal bank account to pay off your mortgage, your student loans, your car payments, everything in one fell swoop. That's pretty incredible.
Rurutu is saying, when is Amazon just going to buy this company, Sonos?
That's a very good question. Well, don't they have the Echo?
Yeah,
no, what do they have?
Their speaker division's not the greatest, though.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I mean, even
but
in
Sonos isn't about speakers.
It isn't?
Yeah, they are. It's
also. No, it is about speakers, but it's also about the infrastructure, the system of it.
Well, I mean, yeah.
I know the speakers are part, don't
but
get me wrong.
That's the big part of it.
Oh, I thought
I mean,
it was
Sonos
about,
is like sound. They're competitors with Bose and Sony. For,
I thought it was more about the system behind that.
No. Mm. I mean, it's integrated well, but it's sound. That's them.
Ironically, I don't have any of their speakers in my house.
What are you talking about?
I have speakers. They're not Sonos speakers. All my speakers were installed 12, 13 years ago.
Oh, I see that. I wondered.
And that's a Sonos system. That's why I thought it was all about the infrastructure. I have the Sonos system in my house.
Oh, Mo, you're getting Paul's house. Are you happy about all this Sonos?
I mean, you must be. I'm going to do some Sonos. I think they're just called Ones.
Ones, yeah. Yeah, those are. They're all on the roof, though. They're all on the ceiling, though, you know.
Yeah. Well, I'm going to leave those. His speakers sound great.
It's incredible.
I'm talking about just put them around the house.
Oh, you know? I love that.
And those speakers in my house are 12 years old. They were installed when I built the house.
Yeah, they're good.
Pillar number seven is free cash flow for Sonos.
So remember, guys, free cash flow is cash from operations less your capital expenditures. This is the money that a company will use to buy back shares, pay dividends, pay off debt, make acquisitions. This is what I look at most over earnings because it's cash in and cash out. It's not manipulated by some tax laws or the SEC. It's cash in, cash out. Can it still be manipulated? Absolutely. But the good news is they had negative $27 million in free cash flow 5 years ago, and they had $128 million in free cash flow this past year. Check mark there.
Okay, check mark for free cash flow growth. What about the middle numbers, Paul?
Negative 9, 30, negative 5, 97.
Wow, it's all over, huh?
Yep.
The average free cash flow is 43?
43 million. The company is 4.5 billion when you take out the extra cash they have on hand. So it's basically like 95. It's an X, 95 to 1. The ratio is 90. The price to free cash flow is 95. We want it to be less than 20.
Uh-oh.
That's an X. So this company is very expensive. And I'll be honest with you guys, where's the growth? The growth isn't huge. Look, if somebody tells me it's a growth company, all I have to do is sit there and say, all right, cool. Growth company? Sick. Its revenue is up 10%, 12% a year. I don't know. How much is this up?
You better not be asking me.
Seth, do 1, 3, 2, 6. Mm-hmm. You know what? Don't do it.
I got it, baby.
No, you don't got it.
Well, that's true.
Trust me, because I have to ask you to do like X to the 1, 3, 2, 6 divided by 843. The power of 0.2 minus 1. It's 9.48% growth. That's your big growth stock right there. 9.48% a year.
You don't want that.
I mean, guys, if I'm gonna pay 95 times free cash flow, I better have 39.48% or something crazy like that. This is 9%. Guys, we're growing double this clip. And I couldn't sell my company for 95 times free cash flow.
Mm-hmm.
And so I'm looking at going, okay, I mean, this is a pass for me. Great product, bad stock.
Mo, you want to talk about Sonos over in the trading aspect of it?
Yeah, let's do it. So the first thing I'm going to point out is we are over all four of our major moving averages and have been for quite some time, going back to November. So those of you that know and have been around for a while, you know that this is a power stock. So this is your perfect power stock that we look for. We look for coming up through the sweet spot and then just going sideways for a very long time on top of that 80%. So each time that you make a new high, you can keep adding to that position. So right now, this goes back to what I was saying this morning on the live stream. When you have a power stock, it's not ideal to get in now because we've just been going sideways for so long. That's like going to the cookie jar, reaching in and grabbing crumbs instead of grabbing the whole cookie. You wanted to start back here. So this is what you look for. Stocks that come up, go through the sweet spot, get to the overbought range, and then just go sideways for months on end. But if you're in this, good job. Go ahead and on the next green engulfing candlestick that takes out the previous 52-week high, go buy it and keep making money on it.
Thanks for watching the video. We hope you were intrigued. If this style of investing speaks to you, click the link below to join our Patreon. As a patron, you get access to a wonderful community of like-minded investors where you can chat, connect, ask questions, and share ideas with badasses like you all over the world. The best part is you get the amazing Everything Money software. This is revolutionary, unlike any YouTube page. Yep. You can track your investments, look at stocks, and quickly run our 8-pillar analysis on any company you like. Yeah. The top tier patrons get direct access to Paul and Trader Mo. You'll see their daily trades, their updated portfolios, and every options contract they write on a daily basis. We provide Patreon exclusive videos just for you, including live streams and exclusive content from our team. Our bottom patron tiers fill fast, so join today. But hey, if you don't believe me, look at all of our patrons' amazing success stories. In comparison to other financial platforms, our software is by far the best value. This is your chance to get serious about investing. Yep. If you're finally ready to level up your investing game, join our Patreon and let's start kicking ass together.